Okay, so today I'm going to share with you something special. This is a nice big moth that I just happened to come across today, and it is known as the Polyphemus moth, and it's here in the United States, and it is found across the country, so they are fairly common. Most people probably just don't notice them because look what it looks like here, kind of a dead leaf hanging in this hazelnut bush. Now I'll give you some details about it, and notice how it's just hanging by one leg there. That's very interesting. Hazelnut leaves are not necessarily easy to grip onto, so given that it's windy and the wind is knocking them around here, this is a pretty impressive cling on here. Look how thick the body is. Heavy with fur. Now, do you think this is a male or a female? I'll give you a second to figure that out. But if you look at the antennae, they're really broad and large. This is a male, and those antennae are used to locate the female's pheromone. So during the day, much like this one is doing right here, they just hang out on trees. Sometimes you'll find them on the wall of your house near a lamppost. If you've got a light source at night, they could be attracted to it. They could land on an adjacent wall, something like that. And how big do they get? Well, this one, when it spread its wings open, is 5 inches, wingtip to wingtip. This is just giving you a close-up of the head, all the hairs that are all over its body. Their only defensive move here is to open up their wings and show you the eyes on it, and that's where it gets its name. Polyphemus is from Greek mythology here, and that is, of course, the Cyclops. And if you look here on the little eyes that are on the side here, they look transparent, don't they? It looks like you can see brown through it, that little eye. And I'm going to show you that later, because when he spreads his wings open, you're going to see the leaves through it, and it's going to look green. Nice close-up again of the antenna here. Now, they don't live long. As large as this is, he doesn't have the ability to eat or drink. So when they develop as a moth, when they develop as a caterpillar, that's when they're gaining all their fat and resources that they will use after they go through metamorphosis and become a full-grown adult moth. Here he is with his wings spread. Again, that's 5 inches tip to tip. Look at all the fur. And he's going to live, I don't know if I mentioned, about 3 days. And as a caterpillar, they just eat a lot of different trees. So anything from alders to basswood, birch, chestnut, elm, hickory, maple, poplar, sycamore. So as a caterpillar, they're not going to defoliate any single tree, so they're not a big threat. As to what they do for us, it's anybody's guess. They just look good. But look through these eyes now. They're transparent, and we see the green leaves underneath. Now, he was threatened a moment ago. That's why his wings were spread wide open. If you pick them up and drop them on the ground, they'll flop and flip around, and they'll show these eyes very clearly, because that's their only defense, is to make themselves look like a large predator and make it seem like they have big eyes. And you can see the green through it. Look how clear that is. Look at this fur. Very interesting. I'm so happy I came across this. And this morning, even, I found a Luna moth, so I'm going to photograph that later. And, of course, another Polyphemus moth was out. So I think we're going to see quite a few of them. And they're very common, as I said. You just have to look for them, as big as they are. I also like to look for Cecropia moths and others like that. But we'll just give you a look at the details here. I'm going to pass my finger underneath the wing there and show you how translucent these little lights are in the eyes of the wings. And normally, of course, I'm videoing bees and things like that, but anything in nature, snakes, frogs, you name it, if I come across it, I'm going to make a video and share it with you. And look how close we are here. This is really good. And you know what? The wind just kept blowing, so it was very difficult to get these shots. Look at the side of this nice heavy body. It looks like he's made out of wool. And again, remember, he's carrying all his resources with him. Here I am passing my finger underneath. Look through that window lower left, and you can see my finger. Very interesting stuff. Very interesting moth. And of course, as it gets dark, he'll take flight again, and he'll try to find a female. That's his whole deal. And I'm glad I got a chance to share it with you. I hope you appreciated that. If you like to see little tidbits like this, go ahead and subscribe if you like. Again, when he's threatened, you can see that these lower wings spread open so that he'll display those eyes. And that's to throw off predators. Here he is again, just on the hazelnut leaves. And glad to share with you. Let me know what moths you've seen in your area. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.